Hello everyone, welcome to the Geek Cupboard. I am Penge, and this is Project Highrise, and this is the Penge Spire. Still not overly spiry, but better than it was, but it's kind of going out left and right more than up to, you know, up and down at the minute. So yeah, we need to do some work on this. So last time out we did a lot of stuff, but alas, we have taken a loan, which was the big thing. But we do have all these things. We've got Buzz. And the current total is 181, and we only need 135. So if we're going to do a lot of building work, it might be wise to take that on, take one of the Buzz options, and see what we can build with that. Also, influence. We can build another one of these. So we had an office manager. There he is. So we can build. We've got the office manager, so he can do all this stuff. So I think we've got that, have we? And yes, we need this. But I know we haven't got that. So we haven't got the extra construction worker, which would cost 15 influence. So we could either do this. So we could build, get a lobbyist's office, an interior decorator's office, which if we come out of that are in one of these somewhere in there. So we could build that because it's 10 influence for each one of those. So it might be a good idea to build a lobbyist, because a lobbyist can bring in people, I believe, using a metro station, which sounds good. And rain will no longer keep people from visiting my restaurants and stores. So that's good. So I might build a lobbyist's office. Now let's see. I'm not so fussed about this at the moment. An aesthetics person, so an interior decorator. I mean, have you seen some of the interior decorating around here? I mean, look, beige. Oh, I hope someone's repairing that. Are you all set to auto do that? Oh, well, let's do that. Let's renovate everything, shall we? Just delegate maintenance. Yes, good. To literally whatever needs it. What restaurant needs doing? Oh, that one. Open your windows if you've got damp. You got windows there. Come on. So, yeah. So, this time round, I think we need to build up this bit. But we need to fill these up as well with these particular offices. These large offices, which are these. So, I think we couldn't have medical professionals, could we? Because they didn't like it. Well, they're not even large offices. They're medium offices, aren't they? So, if we put two of them in. Speed time on a tiny bit so we can see who we can get in. So medical won't join us. They need a greater variety of restaurants that serve breakfast. Clearly the dental clinics and such like are very, very, very picky about their breakfast. These guys will join in, so that's good. So they need a phone line. They also need an office supply. You can't point to it while there, but if you look down the list of happy faces, there's a one in the middle which isn't happy. An office supplies store, which we don't have at present. So do I want to get one of them in first? Also, legal office, they'll move in and they've got everything we need. So they want those things that we've got. So let's put one of those in while we're pondering what to do. And then financial offices, they will need IT and computer repair services, which we don't have at the moment. So it might be wise then to build this bit now. Try and build this bit up as much as we can and stick these extra services that we don't have on there. So we can then have these services that people want. So it's time to have a look at Buzz to see if we have anything that can help us with getting stuff cheaper. So let's have a look. Electrical and water construction and daily costs. Okay. They want to use my building in their latest advertising campaign. They'll let you borrow some workers and reduce my bill. Okay, so electrical will be cheaper. We don't have anything to do with apartments. We haven't got any yet. Increased sales revenue for stores and restaurants from some advertising or loads and loads of visitors. Oh, no weather impact, though. That's quite good. And that's just everybody happy. Phone, construction and daily costs. See, ideally, we'd want that. But that's 215 buzz because we're going to be constructing lots of floors. 50% construction costs. Less for new floor tiles, elevators, stairwells and utility closets. Can I wait a day and see if I get some more buzz? Shall we speed it on a bit and just see how it goes? What time do you guys shut? You're both sort of stood there like spanners. Charles at the burgers and fries place. You haven't even turned the lights out, Charles. You haven't even tidied up. You haven't even tidied the stuff off the tables, Charles. What kind of worker are you? And yes, I actually made money. Hurrah. Good. So I'm in profit, which is nice. So we need to... Why is there a little water closet there? And there's one there as well. I thought I wasn't going to have two lots of them. Okay, I might get rid of that because I'm going to be paying for that. And it's doing nothing, I don't think. Is it doing anything in terms of water? It's just connected. Oh, is it because I couldn't afford to do over there, so I've done it that way instead? Well, shall we connect these water pipes up like that? Because eventually we're going to have a massive grid of water, I imagine. So I don't imagine that's going to be a problem. So, yeah. So do we get rid of that cabinet now? Because I don't think it makes any difference. We're just going to be paying maintenance on that cabinet. So let's get rid of that. Now these have all got water supplied to them. Have they got phone lines up at the top? I think they have. Yep, so they've got phone and electric, so that's good. And they've moved in. Right, okay. So let's wait for some time to pass and see if we get some buzz. And we have. We have got enough buzz. Took us till 3 o'clock just about, but yes. So we can have It's a Steal. So we can build all these floors and things cheaper, which is good, because that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be building floor tiles. Not so much elevators and stairwells and things, but I suppose we could. We could just build... I don't know how much it would cost to build that entire thing up, but let's see. If it's 50% cheaper, let's go for that, please. And now we shall press pause. So, floor pieces. So we're going to just drag them across there. So there are only 6 per go. Oh, yes, we can definitely afford this then. I mean, this is going to take forever to build. The guys are going to take a long time building this, but that's fine. So we can fill all that up. Lovely. Okay, that did cost a little bit more than I thought. But we'll make that back. That's good. Right, so the stairs on the edge. So let's just drop all the stairs in. Oh, they're cheap. And then the regular lifts at the end so everyone can get to different floors. Jolly good. Right, okay. So now we need to speed it forward and they need to build all of that, which is going to take a long time. So do I use that and get an extra construction worker? Because that next one requires an expanded maintenance office, which is the guys who repair all the buildings, the units. But I haven't got +1 construction worker yet. So if I do that, I can then go to this. So let's do that now. Hurrah! So we should see an extra construction worker pootling in from somewhere. There you are. Who are you? Anne. You look good, Anne. You look efficient and fast. Actually, not that fast. You look a bit faster now. I've sped you up. Oh, wow, she's straight to work. She didn't even go into the office. She literally ran into the stairwell and started doing stuff. Why are all these people coming along here? Where are they going? Are they using the lifts that aren't done yet? Okay, they're going into the lifts that aren't complete. Are they sort of abseiling down the lift shaft? What's going on? That's a bit strange. Okay, fine. So they've done the stairs, they've done the lifts, I think, and now we just need them to start working on the actual floor pieces. But that's fine, so we are going to still make profit at the end of this day, so that's good. So they can start chipping away at those. Right, yeah, so they're going to start at the ground floor, which is fine. It's not ideal, I would rather they started at the top, but I suppose they can't do that until the next levels are in, I would assume. So let's wait for them to do that. Whilst my... worker guys already hard at work doing all this stuff. I have updated the game since the last time I played it. We had an update, which is very lovely. And there is now this, a building amenity. So you can build these things. So you can have common areas, which is exciting. You can have shoeshine stations, vending machines, and payphones. So I might, with these spaces here, I might try and fill some up. So how much does payphones take up? Because I've got these objects in it that I don't particularly need. Like that room there is empty. Look, there's nothing in there. So can I put something in there to fill up that space? Ah, this leads me on to something that I should have addressed. The title of this, now, I've decided when I was editing the video, so I recorded the first two parts in relatively quick succession. And then I realised that I could call it Project Highrise Fill Everything. This was discussed in the first episode, I believe, where I basically want to fill in every single gap with something. Now, this is sort of okay, a light and a chair, like a little lobby area, but I kind of consider it to be cheating. It's not really... Whoa, goodness me, that's a lot of money. It's not really what I was sort of thinking. So these other little amenities coming in are actually quite useful, so I could start filling things up. But right now, I need to do that, because that is incredibly expensive. But we need it to be done, because otherwise they will move out. So that's a shame. Right, where are my worker guys? Right, they're flying up here. This is good, because we need up here to be done. Right, let's look at some amenities then. While they're doing that, so how big are the amenities that I've just entirely forgotten how to get to there? So payphones were 2. Vending machines are 2. A shoe shine station is 3. Oh, that's quite good. I could put one there. And a common area is also 3. Ah, okay. So what's a common area do? Oh, goodness me. A communal living space for evening relaxation by apartment residents. Right, okay. So they will be no use. A shoe shine, though, will be good. So that's good. They will use these if they're on the same floor as their office or apartment. Right, so I can't put it there. Payphones, tower dwellers will use these if they're on the same floor as their office or apartment. And vending machines, office users will only visit vending machines that are on the same floor as their office. Oh, so I can't fill those spaces up. Oh, that's a bit irritating, isn't it? But joy of joys, all that's filled up. Hurrah! So let's start putting in some smaller offices along this row here, just to get some people in. So if we build, let's fill it up to the edge of these shops. So that's quite nice. 6 small offices. Let's go for a couple of creatives. Yes, you, and a creative next to you. So that's 2. An accountant, you'll do. Insurance, you don't pay very much, do you? Legal, ooh, 175. Yeah, you're good. We'll have you on board, please. You pay 175. Whoa. And you pay 180. We'll definitely have you. What were you? An insurance one? No. Legal. Yeah, 180. Ward investigations. Yes, we'll certainly have you on board, please. Right. Give them all. Might as well put it all the way to there. And phone, because they're going to need phone as well as electricity. Right. Okay. So we've got some more people able to move in, which is exciting. So let's speed time on and get them in. And we're going to put another place down here for breakfast. So I need to find a medium restaurant possibly, or a small restaurant. Let's put another medium restaurant in that can do breakfast, and let's hope there is one. Do they do breakfast? So we need to put lunch and dinner, lunch and dinner, lunch and diners. They must do breakfast. Breakfast and lunch. There we go. Red Bowl Diner, a sandwich shop, breakfast and lunch. Essentially sausages there. Big R sausages. Big R sausages. Okay, big A sausages and big G's hot dogs. Wow, everyone is big in the sausage industry right now. Okay, salad and hot bars just serve lunch, which is fine. And pizza places must just serve lunch and dinner. Okay, so a diner. Which one paid the most? You. The Red Bowl Diner serves breakfast. So let's pop you in as well. And let's speed time on so all these offices and things are sorted. Right, hang on. What are you going to need? What are you going to need? Water and electric. So let's pause that. Ah, and excitingly, I must have gone up a prestige point. I have gone up a prestige point because I can build some more things. I don't know what. I can build a supply room for my building's custodians. Each supply room supplies up to 3 broom closets. Have I got broom closets yet? Broom closets reduce the accumulation of grime and disrepair on the floor where they're located. Oh! So I could just put broom closets along each bit. Along each floor. Just a little closet at the end. Just to keep all the floors nice and tidy. Is that right? Am I right in assuming this? Ah, well, we'll definitely be doing that. And I can build a medium store. Ah, and it just doesn't fit. Oh, that is deeply irritating. Damn you, shop. Damn you, Red Bull Diner. Okay, fine. So we can't put a retail outlet just there. That is really irritating. We'll have to put one of those in instead, which is a bit annoying. So we'll put another shop in. And can we put a small restaurant in just there? Does that fit? Yeah, okay. Oh, no. We don't want to do that. Get rid of that. Bang. We're going to put our broom cupboard things in there, I think, aren't we? Yes, we're going to need to put a storage thing somewhere at the bottom for it. And then a little kind of cupboard along the edge. So we'll just literally put it there. I don't know how big they are. We need to build the storage bit for it first. So if we can stretch that along to there, which would be quite good, we can then put it level with these and it'll look all nice and symmetrical, which is important. It isn't really important, but it is for my mind. So let's get on with them building that. Let's speed that up. What shop do we want? I don't think we've got an electronics shop. So why don't we pop an electronics shop in? Yeah, why not? Have we got an electronic shop? I don't think we have. No, it doesn't look like we have. Anyway, if we have, they're really rubbish because it doesn't look very good. Southwestern Cellular. They sound good. A mobile phone store. Yes, okay. Let's do that. And let's check that they have all their requisite things. Have they got a phone line? No. So they're going to need a phone line. So let's pop a phone line in for them. And now I am painfully poor. Oh dear. Right, okay. No, let's speed time up. And let's get all these things in. Yes, there was some debate about the era that this was set in. I have been wondering. So yeah, they have very old CRT monitors there. Nothing looks particularly modern, really. Oh dear, that needs some work on it, doesn't it? But yeah, so it's sort of this place here. Oh, right. So yeah, so it is sort of modern. They are big phones. They are big, chunky, old-style mobile phones. So what, 2000s-ish? They look like flip phones, so they were kind of around that era, weren't they? They look like massive old Nokias. Ooh, lovely hat. So, yeah, maybe it's around the 2000s era that this is supposed to be set. I can only assume that is the era that we're looking at. If not, everything kind of looks a bit weird otherwise. So I can only guess that it is that time. Right, let's go and set these guys off to do 330 quid to... dollars, sorry, to renovate a couple of rooms, because that shop looks a bit revolting, doesn't it? The unit is getting worn down. I know. We've got people on it. Don't you worry. Okay, and they made $47. Right, okay. So that was a massive expenditure, because I built a lot of things. So next time out, let's hope we don't spend that much. I mean, there is still money coming in. That's good. It's just not as much as we could have possibly done with. But never mind. Have they sorted that room out? Yes, they have. The shop is back to normal. Right, okay. Let's carry on filling up this with normal size offices, apart from the very end ones. Right. Now we're going to have to be careful here. Let's slow time down. Let's put the stairs in. Don't want to mess this up. Stairs and lift, which is fine. I need to unlock that at some point, because that looks quite good. Exclusive elevators. An upgraded elevator does not need to start on the ground floor. Yes, you could put it here and it can go up to sort of special apartments and things. Right, legal offices, 175. Legal office, 115. And a horrible insurance office for 105. Vigilione insurance. Yes, I'm letting the mafia in. Let's hope they don't break too many fingers. Right, and phone is in and electricity is in. Right. You guys, where was that thing that I could build? Storage, right. A supply room for my building's custodians. Let's put one of them in. So when that's built, hopefully one of these guys will get straight to it. No, they're not. Ah, they're doing the offices first. That's fine. I can cope with that. You're building it. Who are you? Elizabeth. Right, Elizabeth, good job. So we can't... Can we build that? Ah, yes, right, okay, it just needed a refresh type thing. Place a broom closet. Right, how wide are broom closets? 2! Oh, lovely, that's good. Right, so how many does that give us then? So that gives us room for how many? Up to 3 broom closets. So if I went broom closet, broom closet, broom closet, is that 3? So that will serve those 3. Do they need to go and build them? Yes, they do. Right, okay. What does a broom closet look like? He says, which might be a ridiculous question. Is it a cupboard with a broom in? Oh, it needs some water. Of course it does. Let's pause time. Right, okay, here we go. This is going to be expensive, isn't it? I might not be able to afford to put water on them right now. That's why those cabinets were there, wasn't it? Oh dear, never mind. Right, okay. So water needs to come all the way across. And water is very expensive. Okay. Can I get water all the way across there? I don't think I can. Not with that money, anyway. I mean, we're going to need water over there anyway. So do I just put a water closet there? Oh, that's really irritating. And there's one little space just there, which isn't doing anything. Ah, man. Okay, we're going to have a problem here then. So we can't get water to every of those closets. Right, now how much is water? 20. So am I going to blow all my money on getting water all the way over there? I am. Okay, fine. We've got one. They're not going to move out anyway because they're mine. They're my staff. So let's speed time on toward the end of the day and we will have to do something about these at a later date. But this floor is going to be good anyway. Three of those. Yes, it's just a sink, essentially. A sink and some papery stuff. One thing I have wondered is, where are the toilets? I don't know where the toilets are supposed to be in this particular game. I'm not too fussed, but it's just a bit strange that there are no toilets. Let's get you in as well while we're here. Might as well get another person in, another paying punter into the building. Okay, just a quick check shows me that we are running out of... Is it water? Yes. We're running out of water. That is not particularly good, is it, really? So, you know, we've only got one water meter. The demand is 14. Gas is fine, and electricity is fine, and phone is getting there. But water is an issue. So, how much is one of the big water meters? Well, not big, but that. 2,000 for one of those. Okay, let's see what we get at the end of the day and see how much money we've got left. Because we do need to build a proper one. So if we have that, if we have 2,000, let's plumb one of those in. Right, okay, that's fine. So we got 9,470 and we total expenses for 9,125. So how have we got that per day? If yesterday we spent if we earned 9,470 and we spent 9,125, I'd expect 300 odd pounds, but it's gone up quite a lot. Okay, well, I'm not going to question it. That's good. I like that. Hurrah. But yeah, just a bit weird, really. Okay, let's pause it. Pause. We're going to take out that. How many are on it? 14. So let's take this out so we're not paying maintenance on it. And let's put in a big water meter. That one. There we go. So now the demand, yeah, so it's 50. Demand is 14. Good. Right, can we get another water pipe in along here? Can it reach? So I'm probably thinking not still. It can reach all the way along to there. Good. That's another water cupboardy, broom cupboard thing done. So now we need to wait for the next one to come along. There is someone in there. What's he doing? Is he actually using it? You're being hard pressed. There's no water. Right, and they are happy up in that room. Yep, so they're happy. They've got their water back, the little sort of catering thing. Oh, why are they sad? Could not dispose of our trash yesterday. Need more trash bins on this floor. Trash bins? That's a new thing. Okay. Bins. Trash. Trash bins. Okay, do we put them on every floor? Should we build a bit up here for bins? And just stick them in between the cupboards and then put some other sort of boring functional stuff on the other side. That might be quite a good idea. Trash bins get emptied into this trash collection room located in the basement. We have to build the trash bin thing, which is little, and then the trash bin actual big bit, which goes underground, and the recycling bin as well. Okay, fine. Yeah, all right, let's give that a go. Let's build a couple of extra bits this side. It gets more expensive the higher you are. I didn't notice that. And we'll speed up time to get that done. Right, so it's just coming up to 9 in the morning. I've expanded this a little bit because I'm going to put bins and also recycling bins and various other things in on all of the floors. I like consistency. I don't like it if it was all wrong because it would confuse me thinking, well, that floor's got something on, but that floor hasn't got something. Yeah. So, yeah, they're all going to be the sort of same. But I thought I could also put vending machines and other things on these floors to make these guys a bit happier. Okay, these guys are going to have to walk a long way to the vending machines. But still, or I could put a vending machine on one floor and a shoe shine on another or whatever. So, fudge it, we're running out of money. So we're going to have to actually up our money a bit first to then be able to afford all these things. And how is that looking? Hooray! Everything isn't looking worn out. That's rather lovely. Good job, everyone. Good job. We need another couple of these, I think. And we need to be able to put some water all the way over to all these floors, which is going to be very expensive. There probably is a buzz thing. There was, wasn't there, for water, actually. What do I need? 320 for the next one. Crikey. Well, it's on its way, but that's quite a lot. Right, so I have 320, but it's only these first kind of crappy ones. I need these ones, really. Where was the water one? It was infrastructure. Was it not ad placement? So infrastructure operating cost 50% less. That's useful. There you go. Electrical and water construction and daily cost 50% less. Local utility providers want to use them. Okay. Renovation cost, not so bothered. Yeah, again, that's not so useful now because I'm not doing a massive upgrade. Can someone move in here? Medical. Yes, I can actually get medical people in. Hooray. And they've got all the services they need. Ah, they need a water pipe hookup. Ah, because it's a dentist, obviously. Right, okay. Prefers lower floors, that says. Well, it's quite a low floor. So let's drop one of you in, a dentist. And, oh, did they just swap around? Why did they swap around? Oh, I've nearly completed that. I've nearly completed profoundly profitable. That's quite exciting. Okay, let's drop that down because they need water. So they need a phone. They've got electric phone, but they haven't got water. Okay, so they've all got this sort of half plumbed in. Let's drop a water line in to just there. There you go, dentists. In you come. You've got water now. Oh, lovely. A nice big pair of teeth. Pair of teeth? A mouth with some teeth in it. That is lovely. I don't like dentists, to be honest. Yeah, horrible. Right, let's put some smaller offices in just there and there, just to fill up the space. So legal, 165, and legal, 180. Good. Just to get some more money and people in going to the shops. Ooh, what's that? Copy centre. We've got more service calls. Yes, I think we could fill. You need more service centres of this type. Ah, right, okay. The lift is broken as well. It's all falling apart. Right, we need more copy centres. Okay, let's put one at the top then. Okay, yes. Copy centres. Ah, we also need some other stuff, didn't we? So let's put in a copy centre because we're running out of ability. Present, but maybe insufficient. Okay, so let's put you there. So if we put you on the higher levels, that'll be useful for the people at the top. So you've got the people at the bottom to go to the lower one, and they can go to that one. Okay, and what else was there? So that's fine. Not present, no demand. That's fine. IT services were acquired for someone, but I don't know who. I can't remember who, but let's put them in as well. Let's put them in there. Oh, look at that. I wish I could work in an office like that. It looks tremendous. Is the clock different as well to all the other clocks? Because that would be interesting if it was. Those clocks say, what, sort of 25 past one maybe? And that one says something like 9:30 or 10:30 or something. Good, welcome to IT. Hurrah, good job everyone. So we're going to get more copy services, IT support, which is good. Oh, and I've not powered them up. Pause. Yeah, I know. That was a bit of a stupid thing to do, wasn't it? And they're going to need a phone. I know. I'm on it, guys. There we go. Hurrah. Good. So they can go up there for copy, and they can go down there for copy. Oh, you're a bit grim. Rent is too high. We should be paying less. Copy services needed. Well, I've given you copy services. You're saying copy services needed. You're saying rent is too high, we should be paying less. I don't agree with you there, sir. I think you should be paying more payment. Everyone else is happy around there. You're next to the water. Oh, no, right, there's manky rooms. 240, let's get those offices renovated. Come on, folks, chop chop. Right, so my buzz is accumulating very nicely, so hopefully I will be able to have the higher up things, these things and the decent things that we want. I might just do that. I might have a commercial promotion, increase sales revenue for stores and restaurants. That'll keep people in, or 50% more visitors, which will haul people in, which means that's sort of the same thing, I imagine. They'd get more people into the restaurants. I'd rather do that with the tube station thing. Speaking of which, next time around, after we've been paid, let's put that in. Let's put the, they're on that floor, aren't they? Is that the, where's the design man? There, building manager. So on this floor as well, let's put the, whatever it is, the you. Where is it? Where are you? You, the political thing. The lobbyist, that's it. And then he can get us an underground station, which will be quite cool. Hurrah! So I earn 10,000 a day. Was it a 10,000? Must be. So, yes, I now have a new contract to choose, which is good. Okay. I don't understand this at all. If my revenues were 9965 and my expenses were 9968, surely I shouldn't have made any money. I don't really understand. I'm going with it, because that is lovely and I've got cash, but I don't really understand. Okay, fine. You, Mr. Man, come here. We need a lobbyist. So let's put you just there near the IT services. Come and help us do our thing, lobbyist man. So you can build that. And the first thing we want to do with Mr. Lobbyist is, there we go, is, what have we got there? Oh, we can build a two-bedroom apartment. That will be another job at some other point later on. So using this now, we can, we need one more. We can get a metro station, which would be brilliant. That would be cool, wouldn't it? A metro station somewhere here near the stairs and the lift, or possibly there. Walk past the horrible smelly office. It's fine. Don't worry about that. Let's plumb that room in as well while we're here, because we might as well. Now we've got some money to spend on it. There we go. And that lift is broken. That is tremendous. Oh, good. Speed that on. Why is that still saying it's got no power? Oh, did I? Oh, I've not put power across that floor yet, have I? No, of course I haven't. Okay, fine. It now has power. Oh, he might need power as well. And possibly a phone. Imagine if he's a lobbyist, he's going to need a phone, isn't he? Good. Right, someone's mending the lift. Is there anything else that needs to be repaired by you guys? No. Okay, let me ponder what to do next. Here we go. These people wanted bins up here, didn't they? They couldn't get rid of their rubbish. Couldn't dispose of our trash. We need more trash bins. And it might be the same for other things. I don't know if these places get rid of trash or stuff. So let's put bins. Let's do some bins, which is really exciting. So, bin. There you go. And let's put a recycling bin in as well. Oh, they're only one. They're only tiny. Okay. So a recycling bin. And then let's put one of these on. Let's put a little amenity in. Perhaps a vending machine. That might be quite nice for you guys up there. So you guys across the top can do that. Hurrah. Now we need somewhere for the bins to go in the basement somewhere. So let's build one of these. And let's put this over kind of this end here. So we're going to want a few of those. How big are they? Bigger than that by one square. So if we put that there, is that going to work? They're what, five squares? Yeah. So if that's four, that's five. So we build that there. That's going to fit. Is it five squares? No, six squares. There. Let's put that there. Right. Having had a look at these, look, we are running out definitely of power, but more crucially, we're running out of phone. And it might be a good chance to use one of these things. I think it was that one. Exclusive electricity, electrical and water construction, daily cost minus 50%. So if I do that, can I move that out of the way? No, okay, fine. So that, I could use that to then construct another one of these closet things at a bit less. The electricity is less for that day anyway, and then I could get water across the other side of the building to all the other janitor cupboard things. So that might be the best use of that. So let's do that. 385, I've got loads of that left, it's fine. So is time ticking on? No, time is paused. Right, so let's rejig these a second. Right, so electricity. Now, yes, lots of capacity for that. 150. We've only used 88. That's good. Phones. We were just in the limit, but now we've upped that. Water is still fine, but we have also got all of the floors all watered. It only costs 5 per square rather than whatever it was before. 10, presumably. So we can put a couple more of these in now. So we can put another one of those in. We're going to need another 2. So let's build another couple of floors as well, if we can. We might not be able to do that properly. Yeah, we haven't got enough money to build the rest of it. We can at least get that in. Oh no, they can't get there. How about we put some stairs in? There we go. That's a bit more sensible, isn't it? How much is a lift? And let's put the lifts in as well. Right, okay, so let's get the workers on that. It was very early on when we spent all our money, so now we've just got to sit and just kind of wait, and we want to build a couple more of those and then some more of those on those floors to stop all the offices that we're eventually going to fill up here kind of going a bit scabrous and mangy. Is there anything for you to do? No. Good. Okay, so that's fine at the minute. So we need to wait for the end of the day, and then we can build this, presumably, and then build the little broom cupboardy things on those floors and some electric. Oh, what's that? I can build a large restaurant. We're going to have a floor at some point where it is all sort of restaurants and things again. So what's a good floor for that? Floor 10? Yeah, I think floor 10's a good floor. Good view out the windows for that. So a couple more floors and then large restaurants and big shops and things. So that's quite exciting. It's a bit way off, but we'll get there. They're still whinging about the fact that they've got more service calls. Okay, right. Well, that place presumably is either not. You can't see how busy they are. It tells you what they're doing. Right, okay. That's fine. So, yeah, I don't understand. By that token, I should have lost money, but anyway, whatever. Ah! Oh, dear. Right, okay. I can only have one of these until I am on 8 prestige, which I'm not. Not quite at 8 prestige yet. I need 165 or contracts and things. Ah, I haven't filled in a contract. Let's pick one of those. Increased density or office drones. What do I need to do for that one? Office drones looks like a cheap, easy one to finish. Many downstream benefits to the city. They eat at restaurants, shopping stores, and money in the town. The Department of Planning and Development would ask for your help to attract more of them. Have 50 office workers in your building. I think I've already achieved that. Hooray! Go me! More commuters. What's that? I get 130. Ooh, that's close. Or increased density. The city's planning commission has decided that your area is ripe for development and would like to take the lead by having 100 people live or work in your building. Pay 1,000 up front. Have I not got 100 people working in my building as it is? Yeah, I've got 130 and they're visitors, aren't they? Well, let's do that. Hooray! Go me! People magnet. Since you've already done so well in accommodating a high density building, the planning commission would like you to cram even more people into your building. They'll advance you a bit more. Yes, to start you off. Reward your accomplishment once you reach population of 250 people. Okay, that's a bit more plausible, but you get prestige for that. With that is office workers for up to 150. But you get buzz for that, whereas that's prestige. I'm going to sign that one. That's more likely, well, certainly more useful. Yeah, let's go for that. Good job. And yes, then we need another point of prestige, but we need some more people anyway. So we're going to build some more of these offices. We're going to have a whole row of those now we've acquired money from doing contracts that were instantly completed. So let's pop all these offices in place. And a new floor is complete. Hurrah! There we go. That's quite nice. And we can put something over there as well for them. So we need to speed time on a little bit to get that bit in. Who do we want? Yes, we might have to take some rubbishy people and wait for other options to come in. So you, legal offices will have you, and creatives will have you. There we go. And these ones will have to stay empty. However, we can now put these in, the big offices at the top. So shall we have two of those? And we can finally move some people in. So we need a creative professional. So let's get Pinnacle Industrial Design. And they need an office supplies store. Okay, let's pause it a second. Office supplies store. Office supply services. Not present, no demand. Well, things change, don't they? Now you are in demand. Let's put you there. And you... What else do we need from there? So we're going to have three creatives. What about a medical professional? Can we get another medical person in? Medical clinic. Or should we put all the medicals on? Where's the big smiley face? There. Should I put all the medicals on that floor? Or no, let's put the other two medicals up there. Oh no, they don't like high floors, do they? Was that a silly mistake by me? Probably. Let's put one under there then. Speed time on a second. And the last medical office can be you. Good. Let's build some more big offices while we can. Why not? Let's build two more there and there. So we're going to have enough medical, enough creative. Right, finance. Do finance want to move in yet? Are they happy now? Yes. Yes, they are. Finance. And another financial office can go just there. And that can be the last financial office. Right, okay, speed time up and let's see how that goes. And then we need to check the services. Right, they've stopped whinging finally. That's good. Oh, pause. This is a common issue. I need to do this properly. Let's get that in. Oh yeah, I've got my bonus to that. Yeah, what an idiot. Let's do that. And do that. and phone as well. I don't think I get a bonus to that. I think it's going to be as expensive as it normally is. Everything is plumbed in. Everything is done. You have a phone. Start whinging. Unless the phone's at overcapacity again all of a sudden. No. You've got a phone. Stop whinging. You've got one. You have a phone. Do you? Do you have a phone? Ah. Sorry, my bad. No phones for you. You've got one now. Oh, you're angry, but you've got a phone. Look, pick it up and listen. There's a dial tone. It's really good, the dial tone. Don't move out. Crikey. Okay, I've got another $3,000 from completing that contract. I have a fear he's going to move out, but... Okay, let's look at what other contract we can get. Ah, that's residential. So I'm not going to do that quite yet. So let's do that then. So we want to get the number of office workers to 150, which I have. Hooray for $4,500 and 100 buzz. Thank you. What? Is that not complete? The number of office workers. Ah, no, it's not office workers. That's everybody, isn't it? Of course. Yes, we've got 78 office workers out of 150. 43 influence there. I didn't notice that. What can we spend that on? Let's have a look. Ah, I can build two things. This is good. So I can get an expanded maintenance office that can automate renovations. That sounds rather useful. And a metro station. I can see no disadvantage to both of these. Let's unlock a metro station. Oh. Ah, it becomes more expensive. Okay, well, we'll get that next, because that's going to be... We'll get two influence in not very long at all. Any of these available yet? Nope. Right, where's the metro station? Transit. Build a metro station. 5,000 to build it. Oh, my goodness. Where can that go? Can it just go anywhere? Kind of ideally want to put it near the middle, so they can get to the lifts and things. Yeah, that's not really near the middle. Let's put it near the edge. I don't want it to be near the bins. That's just rubbish. Literally. Let's build some more floors. And we'll move those cupboardy things somewhere else. So let's just expand those floors out a bit. In fact, you know what? Why don't we just expand that floor to meet that one for now? And we'll put our metro station in here somewhere. So they can go straight in the lift and go in without having to go past either the bins or the janitor cupboard. So yes, we're going to put another one of those in there when we get the right amount of prestige. We only need 10 more people. That's not many offices. Is everyone happy? Everyone looks happy. Okay, right. And the buzz is accruing. And yeah, let's do that. Oh, height limits. Yeah, let's not worry about that right now. Optimize maintenance. So let's also build a funky maintenance office. Where is that? There. A large maintenance office. Let's put that there. Jolly good. And we'll get some more people in and they can then automate these improvements. I don't know how that works. Let's find out. Ah, as simple as that. There is a tick box. Automate renovation. Yes. Go and do the jobs that need to be done, please. I don't want to keep having to tell you. I'm glad you're springing into action, fellas. Hey, there you go. $480. Okay. Right. I need to get paid and then the metro station can go in because it costs $5,000. So it'll leave me with $1. That's a bit more like it. Right, transit, metro station. There, that's good. I like that. And 162 population. Ah, anyone moving in? An insurance office and a creative office. Yeah, a model agency, lovely, good. You can move in. And that should push us to 8 prestige, which means I can build another one of these cupboards, which means I can build all those things up there. To essentially keep those rooms in repair. Yep, no more of those. Right, let's wait for them to build all this stuff. Is that automatically built? Oh, okay, fine. Visitor count shows how many visitors. Right, yeah, so tomorrow we should see that go up a bit. I don't know what it's been at normally. And then these shops and things should be saying, yay, business is booming, because everyone can now come in and shop and go to these things. That's good. Okay, yes, look, there's a lot of people coming in. It peaked at about 30. Oh, there you go, back up to 30 again. That's good. So they'll be going to the shops and things, which is useful. Right, we've got a bit of money. Why don't we build some more offices up there? So should we have a... we're running out of people for the small offices. So let's have another couple of big offices. Well, medium size, isn't it, on there? So creative or legal or financial. Yep, you're fine. You can move in. Good. In fact, the IT services are only a floor down from you. And creative, yes, let's have you. And that will push my prestige up as well. In fact, why don't we just put a couple more of those in, like that, and that, and that, and that, because then we can still have those cupboards on the edge. Right, 780 for renovating 5 units, you dear. Right, legal, you. Legal, you. Legal, you. Arbitrary, whoa. Piotrowski, Vlahos, and Gallagher intellectual property law. You need to shorten your names, because that is just ridiculous. Hey, and prestige. Prestige has gone up, which means I can build another one of these cupboards. Oh, the excitement. Prepare yourself, everyone. If I can figure out where it is. Boom, another cupboard. And now I can build 3 more little tiny cupboardy things here. So one there, one there, and one there. So now what do I need my prestige to be for the next one? What do I need? 11 prestige. Right, okay, so I'm going to need to do a lot of work. But for the most part, that's where the bulk of the people are. This floor's a bit bereft, isn't it? But yeah, so that's good. That's good. We'll have that for now. Right, might as well put a medical office in while we're there. They've got water. Everything's got water. Prefers lower floor. So yeah, you're quite low. You're not particularly overly high up. Legal office, we'll have you. And creative office, we'll have you. So there we go. A few more people moving in. That should bump that up. Well, both of these, actually, because it bumps up the population and the office workers bit. So that's quite useful. Okay, I've just had a look at some of the things on here. You can have all the exciting things, which it's now not doing. But yes, the satisfaction. So these people, all the shops and stuff, are really quite happy. They're all very jolly. But it's these guys in the middle, in the smaller offices, that aren't too pleased because it says their rent is too high. So how can I just drop the rent generically for everybody for that type of office to be a bit less? How would I go about doing that? Let's try and find out. Ah, right, in here it must be. Just there. There we go. Offices. Can we drop that? How tragic is it going to be? 90%. That's probably a very stupid thing to do. But let's do that and let's see if that improves their satisfaction rating any. Because I don't really want them all to move out. That would be bad if all those guys in the middle just left. So all the offices cost has gone down. So I should expect a little bit less monies. Wow, and the buzz is flying in. I might do that. Which one? That next. Just sales revenue for stores and restaurants. Do that. 580 buzz. Loads of buzz going on. Okay, good. Right, the tower is buzzing. Right, just looking at this, I saw some of the bits accrued some influence. The next thing we want to do really is that. All service workers, so couriers, delivery people, the bottled water guys, work 50% quicker. That sounds very useful indeed. We definitely want that at 35 influence. We are accruing it a little bit, so it's gone up a little bit. Maybe tomorrow, at the end of tomorrow, we will have that. So that'd be quite nice. And then they can obviously, all these people can work quicker around this whole building, which would be very useful indeed. What can we put up here then? So we've got some space along here. Nothing really fits in. So the big offices are too big. The little offices, we could put a small office in. Yeah, it's a bit rubbish, isn't it? Why don't we put some of these amenities in? Why don't we drop some of those? Ooh, hello, in. Okay, right, good. Right, let's slow time down. Can we put someone in that room yet? Yay, legal office, you pay more. Good, it's full, good. Let's drop in one of these then. So do we want to put one of those in? One that we haven't got, maybe. Ah, right, I can't do any more. New prestige 9 for the rest of them. Okay, so none of them are overworked at the minute by the look of it. New, okay, so we don't need any of those. So let's put some of these in then. A shoeshine station. Why not? Requires an electrical connection. We've got that. Let's put a shoeshine station there. It's a bit of a random thing, isn't it? And then I think vending machines are only a couple. So a vending machine. And then on maybe some payphones? Yeah, why not? Let's put a vending machine in and we'll come back to that space. We'll come back to what we can do with that gap. But we must remember it's there because we need to fill everything. Like a scary amount of money going on. But I think it's also time. We're not going to fill that up yet. But I think if we go to floor 10, let's try and head to a floor 10. So let's build a whole new floor on here because we've got some money at the moment. And then another one. Oh, hello. They're going to say, I can't get to that one. And I don't think we'll be able to afford that floor. Can we just bulldoze that particular bit? There we go. So they're going to need some stairs to get up initially. So stairs. Let's keep it consistent. Stairs, stairs, and stairs. And then lift. We're going to need a couple of lifts in as well. There we go. Massive infrastructure project going on. So we're nearly at floor 10. The plan for floor 10, once we get there, is to have more restaurant-y things and shops and big shops. So I can have big restaurants and medium stores now, which is good. What's that? A large two-floor store? Or that's a luxury goods store. How far do I need to get a gourmet restaurant? 13 prestige. Okay, that is quite some way off. Okay, right. We won't hold my breath for that right now. However, I have noticed these gaps can be filled up by some of these things. So let's fill the gaps up. I think it was shoe shines were 3, weren't they? Yeah, let's put them on. Why not? Yeah, it fills the gap up. Good. Gap is filled. That is useful. And they might use it as well. Let's see how used these are. How used is that vending machine? Oh, it doesn't say, does it? Does it not tell you how useful they are? They're just there because of... I don't know why they're there. Okay, it doesn't tell you how used they are. Okay, that's fine. There's someone sat there, though. Uh-huh. There's someone getting his shoe shined. Yes, good job. Uh-huh. Well done, Bernard. This game has the best names. Bernard. Uh-huh. I like you, Bernard, at that ridiculous name. Albert O. Poskowski, LLC. I need a brief distraction. Why? What's wrong with you? Just have an empty floor here. I'm tempted to just do the same again with these small offices and just fill them up as we go. So let's do that now. Get all the small offices in. And yeah, then once they're all constructed, 210 maintenance. So we need to pick whoever we can pick at the minute. So yeah, this is going to be a slow process of filling them in. It's going to be very, very boring. Hey, there we go. Happy tenants. So that's good. Oh, and I can build lots of things. These are flashing on and off. That must be a good thing. And optimize service. Yes, please. Let's do that. Next is what? Exclusive elevators. Ah, good. That is not particularly useful. I'm not even near 40 floors yet. So the next one to get is this one. The aesthetics person. And we'll get some prestige boost. So yeah, that's good. Let's get this top floor finished. Now, they're complaining again about courier services. So do we put another one in over this side, over here, to then make sure that everyone can have courier services? Because we don't want them to be sad and run out. Courier services may be insufficient. Okay, well, let's put one up there. And you can get in there and build that. And that should... Ah, no, they're not going to have any kind of wiring in, are they? Because I've not put that in yet. Pause. Stop. Halt time. Let's put these in. Let's get all this wired up. And alas, I've ran out of money. So my phone line comes to about here. So it seems that they can function without a phone line. Even though... Oh, it's power. Yes, but so my phone line has reached here. So they've got power. They don't need a phone. I don't know how the hell they communicate. But yes, they haven't got a phone line, unfortunately. Sorry, people there. So I'll have to wait till I get paid before the next... before I can put the rest of the phone lines all the way over there. Which, yeah, isn't too bad. That's fine. Whoops. Buzz is accruing very readily, so we're going to have to spend that on something. And I might spend it on a shop-based thing. Let's just bung someone in. What's that? The building needs improvement before this tenant will move in. Ah, oh no, it doesn't. No, you're lying slightly. I just haven't got enough money to offer you to sort of bribe you in. But don't worry, you at midnight we shall have this. Right, so $3,902 in. That is very welcome. So we can employ, kind of lure this person in because I couldn't afford the build cost. So we'll get another person in. So that's good. All goes toward these numbers here. And yes, now we need to look at what we want to do with the rest of the monies. We also want to do this. So what does that do? So foot traffic, 50% more visitors from the city for 24 hours. So that'll be a full day of extra people coming in. Or do we do that? Sales revenue for stores and restaurants. I think that might be quite good. It costs less than the other ones. And it means that they'll just get a nice boost. A lovely boost. Oh, that might be quite good, though. If people are sad. Do you know what? We'll save up for that one, shall we? Let's do that for now. Let's get everyone happy. We've sort of convinced them by the power of media that they are happy. Be happy, all you lot. Stop whinging. And yes, I think that looks very good right now. Look at that. Let's get the phone line in. Phone line all the way to the end, because why not? And I think That is a great point to stop. I think we've done pretty well. This whole bit has been added. So we've got all this. We've got two extra floors. We've got some stuff. We've got a metro station, which is good. Hang on, there's someone in there. You. Hello, Joanne. How are you? And that you make a good noise. Hi, Joanne. Wow. Oh, you've gone. Okay, bye. Metro station must shut at 6:30 in the morning. Shift change. Come on. Ah, there we go. And it's Patsy. Patsy and Joanne are our metro station experts. Good. So I think we've done pretty well. I think that is very good at the minute. We're earning a load of buzz. So all the people will be happier, which we might be able to check, in fact, via that. Yes, there we go. That still is struggling. Courier services. But I've put another courier services in, I believe. So they should be all right once maybe a day has to tick round, so they're not quite as pressured. But okay, so we'll switch that off. So yeah, I think that's good. Next time round, we fill these up with just normal stuff. And then we put floor 10 on, which is going to be full of exciting things like this, like big restaurants and slightly less small stores and other probably interesting things, maybe some vending machines and stuff. But yeah, we could put some art in, possibly. Can we put art in? No, let's not put any art in. We could, in theory, build the final office of the contracted people, the contractors. We could build the aesthetics office. Do you know what? Why don't we do that now? That's tiny. That's not right, is it? That's a tiny office. Okay, well, let's put him there. If they're in, what's the first thing that they do? Small artworks, 45 influence, which isn't too far off. And we get a small prestige boost. All right, well, let's do that. Let's try and unlock that. Once we've got all our stores and things on that level, we won't fill it up, and we'll try and put some small artworks on there as well. That sounds jolly lovely. So, yes, it is going well. It's going apace. And, yeah, maybe next time do we spread out that way as well? Maybe we'll level it all up so it's a nice square, because that's really irritating. But that's for another time. So for now, thank you very much for joining me in the Geek Cupboard, and I will see you next time. Okay, and a boat has majestically hopped up onto the cliffs of Dover. Well done, boat. I have a terrible feeling that part of your hospitality involves putting me in a big, big metal pot on top of a fire and cooking me. I've seen Indiana Jones. I know what you are like. Did Gandhi just turn me down? I've been spurned by Gandhi. The Tlatwani. God, can you just call yourself Malcolm? Wow, that was the most nimble repairing of a pasture I've ever seen. Although I haven't really seen anyone ever repairing a pasture. Maybe that's how it always happens, I don't know.